Hey guys, welcome to the National MX Update Show presented by our friends at O'Neill MX. I'm with the big winner chicken dinner guy, Jeremy Martin of the Monster Energy Star Racing Team. Congratulations isn't enough for the home track win this weekend. How did it feel?
Yeah, man, I don't know. I mean, I know it's the hometown and I'm supposed to win, right? Like people say, oh, it's literally JMart's backyard. He needs to win this thing. Like if he doesn't win, what's going on? What's the deal? So, I didn't know if I was gonna be able to pull it off, man. I was like in qualifying, I was like P5 and I was just way back there, you know, way off. And I'm like, man, this is a hometown race. If you're gonna qualify good, today would be the day.
Yeah. Right.
And, I guess I just pulled it together somehow.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, yeah, sure. It's your backyard and all that, right? But it's prepped far differently for a national than for a regular day, right?
Yeah, definitely. That's one thing I think, like, when I was younger, when I first turned pro, obviously I kind of knew the track or whatever and whatnot. It was comfortable. But as time goes on, my dad hauls in a lot more dirt for just specifically for this event. Mm-hmm. They build the jump faces twice as tall. Yeah. And the bumps, honestly, guys, form a lot different. Like, mm-hmm. when I ride during the week, it's just my goat trail. It's whatever. But then on race day, you know, there's a lot of fast guys. The bumps form at different times. Like, even going down Bob's, the first turn right there, you make that right. And then you make that sweeping right where AC lost his front end.
Mm-hmm.
Or Kenny Crasher along on his 250 back in the day. That form's completely different than what I normally ride during the week or what a local race would provide.
Yeah. So just now you said goat trail, right? You know when you go to the Supercross tracks in California during the week and you guys are riding on this much of the track?
Yeah.
Is that how precise you are at Millville when you're riding there?
Yeah, absolutely. Like I just ride the same line most of the time. I mean, I'll just for something different to work a couple things, like keep the eyes, you know, in check, just go ride something else, obviously, but or take a different line. But I think the biggest thing is I just hit the same line during the week and work on perfecting that, hitting your marks. And then honestly, it gets pretty difficult in some spots to be able to maintain hitting that line,
mm-hmm.
Versus moving over a couple feet because it's just back to being smooth again. So, it can get boring, but it can get tricky.
Yeah. Okay, so this morning on our other podcast, A-Ray goes, dude, the jump faces were so steep. And then just now you mentioned your dad built them up twice as big. Talk about the jumps this weekend, how they're different.
Man, it's just like every year for the National, they just make them massive. Like, and I told Shane Schaefer comes in and does the track work and just takes a lot of load off my dad. Because, like, let's be honest, my dad is a man of many hats on the National weekend. He's has to answer to the Coombs, and then he has people from, you know, that are doing trash or, you know, just doing stuff out in the campsites and all that stuff. So everybody's like, hey, what does John think of this? What does John think of that? So to bring a track guy in, just solely to focus on the track stuff is kind of takes a load off my dad, right?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I told Shane this year, I was like, man, you just blow my back out every year. Because you make the lips so tall and there's no landing, it feels like, you know?
Yeah. Okay, so, man, you know, we've had some pretty cool conversations over the past couple months, and it's awesome to see that you made a return, you know, with the broken fingers and struggling with the wrist and the shoulder and all that.
Yeah.
How are you right now? Do you feel 80%? 90, 100?
Yeah, I'm definitely not 100%, but I'm getting better, right? Like, I'm still not able to ride during the week without having to take some, like, Advil or Aleve or something to help take the edge off the pain. So, you know, I finally feel like the fingers in the hand are getting back to normal. The scaphoid still really bothers me, but I dealt with that before the season, so to me it's just like that's just part of the game. But significantly, like the grip strength and to be able to maintain holding the grip is getting a lot better throughout a 30 plus two twice. So that's been a big deal.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, obviously it was the right choice then, right? Like for a little bit you're thinking about getting everything fixed and all that, and you said no. I gotta stay out there and earn a ride for next year.
Yeah, for sure. I think the biggest thing is, you know, I missed all of Supercross, right? So, you know, with that in my mind, when I did get hurt at Thunder Valley, I was like, man, I'm going to have to go get fixed up. And what a terrible year, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So I just went up, talked to my doctor at the Stedman Clinic, and we looked at everything, and we had a really good conversation about, you know, where I'm at physically and then what could be potentially possible. And, you know, we looked at the pros and the cons, and it just kind of got to a point where we all agreed on, hey, let's put you in a cast for your fingers and try to stabilize the fracture, and then I'd like to see you race. Mm-hmm. You know, and if the pain is too gnarly or you get too far behind from that 3 week or 4 week break, then we can pull the plug and we can get you fixed mm-hmm. for next year. But you know, I think you should try to fight through this, and you know, and that's kind of where I'm at right now. And I'm glad I've done it, right? I'd rather be at the races on the weekend trying, even if I'm getting beat, than mm-hmm. just sitting on the couch and just watching.
Yeah. Yeah, so one thing no one could ever accuse you of is being soft. I mean, you're obviously a fighter. You're willing to push through the pain and get the job done.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it definitely gets more and more sore and aggravated as the day goes on. The swelling starts coming up or whatever, even in the hand and the scaphoid. But I don't want to make excuses about it, man. We all struggle with stuff, and everybody's path is different. You know, a guy like Dungy, it's amazing how he got through his career. He had some injuries and stuff like that, but I don't know, man. I haven't been that fortunate, I guess you could say. So, you know, I just love what I do, and I want to be out there. And mm-hmm. then we know it's a short window. So, and I know I'm probably going to have arthritis when I get older one day. So I accept everything, and I just want to be out there.
You just got to have faith in supplement technology, right? It's going to get better when you're older. Yeah. So, has anything come together for you for next year? Because like that was a big point of discussion.
That's been something I've been working on a little bit. You know, obviously there's a lot of people out there that aren't too happy that I'm already in the 250 class, and there's a lot of comments about it. But I can honestly tell you I'll be on the 250 again for next year.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not supposed to say where or when when we'll announce it.
But you're not stressing?
Not anymore, no.
That's great news, man. Yeah, because, I mean, the options, like when you were hurt, right? We were talking on the phone, and, like, the options were grim. Like, if you had to move up, there weren't a lot of opportunities. And
No, it was going to be tough. I mean, when you move to the 450 class, obviously you want to be on a really competitive bike that has the resources to be able to bring out the best in your riding style, right?
Yeah.
And that's a big thing. You're doing a lot more rounds, and I could go up and I could, you know, be a privateer and stuff, but I don't think I would lose, you know, and I'd be already at a loss because I wouldn't have the resources to kind of be able to be competitive with guys and be in a position, be, you know, where I think I would honestly be in the 450 class. So, just stay down, and I'm not dominating the 250. So I think until I dominate 250 and I kind of click Supercross and then I click an outdoor, I think that then that's the appropriate time. And I think a lot of people in the industry would agree with that. Mm-hmm.
You know what, though? I mean, think back to your Daytona 450 race, right? I mean, the potential and the ability is definitely there.
Yeah, but swap, to be the devil's advocate, people say that's not a full Supercross, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Either way. So, man, that's really good news. How long is that kind of the little bit of certainty about next year been in your program? Have you been feeling good for a couple weeks now?
Yeah, it's been a couple weeks, you know, and it didn't change my mind whatsoever. Like, even when I felt I signed the deal, I was like, all right, man, it's time to really kind of buckle down here and build some character and see if we can get back up front.
Yeah. So the hand, right? It's the two outer fingers?
Yep.
On your left hand or your right hand?
My left hand.
Your left hand. Okay. So thinking about it. Are you a middle finger clutcher?
These two.
Oh, you use two. So you're holding on just with the two bad fingers then.
Well, yeah. So that was the tough thing. Like at Red Dog when I rode, I didn't have the I could barely move these two on the outside that were broke. Mm-hmm. So when I would go to grab the clutch, I couldn't grab the clutch. So in practice, I realized pretty quick, I was like, man, like, this is not good. Like, I can't execute a turn. How am I going to get through the day? So I actually ended up shifting down to first gear a lot to get the torque and to save me in a lot of the deep, like, kind of really kinked out turns.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I grab the clutch, it just hurt too much.
Yeah. And are you still wearing the brace on your wrist?
No, I wish I could, but right now, when I came back before Red Blood, I wore the brace. I didn't wear the brace. I wore the brace. I didn't wear the brace when I was practicing. Mm-hmm. And the biggest thing I noticed was that I kind of had to change how I rode to come back to be able to race. So with the brace, it really stabilized my wrist. Mm-hmm. It was phenomenal. It helped take the load off. But the problem was that it made the pressure point on the bar worse. Yeah. My fingers.
Yeah.
So when I didn't wear the brace, I could actually kind of like, this sounds crazy, kind of cocked my wrist a little bit to help take the load off of the fingers.
Use your palm more. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Hey, Anton said that your white grips look like a butcher shop cutting board after the race this weekend.
Yeah, man. I tell you what, like I haven't been doing my motos during the week because I've been trying to save my body and save my hand, right? So,
yeah.
I mean, I just full on blew up. I got blisters on this hand, and then I got a blister on my right hand, and I was just like full send.
Yeah, nice. So, hey, we were talking about that in our Kickstart podcast, and A-Ray says you got to pee on your own hand in the shower, and it heals your blisters faster. Have you ever heard that?
I don't know if I've ever heard that. I don't think I'm going to try it.
Well, I know it's true for like a jellyfish sting or something, but I've heard
jellyfish deal, but I don't think I'll be maybe just put some new skin or something on there and just call it good.
Yeah, you'll leave it at that, right?
Yeah.
Cool. So, what is the plan in the off season? Will you get your wrist fixed or?
Yeah, absolutely. I was thinking about doing that. Honestly, I need to call the doctor. I need to schedule a surgery date. Preferably the sooner the better, right?
Yeah.
So I think most people will be enjoying the season being over, and I think I'll be going under the knife to try to get fixed up.
Yeah. And then shoulder as well, or is that getting better?
It just kind of depends on where, if I can make it through the rest of the year. Obviously, I do have some issues with it. I can feel it and whatnot, but I think that's a decision I will make with my doctor when the time comes. You know, I mean, that could be something where first and foremost I'll get the wrist fixed. You know, obviously with the bone being broke, it could die, the scaphoid, the bone, and that's a common thing that a lot of people don't know about. And then I could get that fixed first, and then I would get the shoulder fixed I don't know, either this, you know, a week later or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
Yeah,
right on. Well, hey, going back to the race win, how did this one feel, man? I mean, it's 1-1 at the home track, 1-1 under these crazy circumstances where you're riding through pain, right? Is it?
Yeah, I think this one is pretty special just because obviously it is a hometown deal, and I said I'm expected to win, but I haven't won really much this year, and then I haven't gotten an overall yet at all, supercross or outdoors. So I think to get it and then to get it under these circumstances swap is pretty special.
Yeah.
You know, even if it is a hometown advantage, whatever, I'm still not riding 100%. And it was pretty special, man. When I passed into the lead at the bottom of Mount Martin down there in Moto 1, I mean, dude, they erupted. It was like last year, last lap, Moto 2 with Dylan and I just going crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, dude, that was quite the pass, too, dude. Like, you're sending it.
Yeah, kind of. Honestly, I was like, dude, I'm all that work to go down that hill that fast, you know, and then all of a sudden I'm just going to blow it and give them the inside back. I was like, dang it, man.
Yeah. So what was that like? I mean, you're battling with your teammate who's obviously in championship contention. I mean, that's probably all out the window, right, when you're racing for wins.
Yeah, I mean, Jay Coop has to win this thing on his own, you know, right? So
mm-hmm.
That's how I was in the past when I battled Webb. And I think if the time is necessary, I think we will, as a team, make a decision on what is best if he's still, you know, in it and doing his deal. But for right now, I think there's a lot of racing left.
Yeah.
And I don't really wouldn't say there's any tactics or anything in it right now. And I think you'd agree with that.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, hey, dude, I'm certainly really happy for you to see you able to rebound from the adversity that you've had to fight through early the season. And
thanks, man. I appreciate that.
Yeah, and thanks for the time. And I look forward to seeing you this weekend in Washougal. Hey, did you use the Chipotle card yet?
Yeah, it's good. I forgot to. I said I was going to do that. I post about it.
Yeah.
I forgot to do that.
Well, it's all right. Maybe we'll do it again at Washougal.
Fastest man in the whoops, baby, and I get a Chipotle card.
All right. Well, hey, guys, thanks for watching. Jeremy Martin, thanks for joining us on the MX Update show presented by O'Neill, and we'll see you this weekend.
Okay. Thanks, Swap.
Bye-bye.
See you.